Hello, this is Pam, Flower Patch Farmhouse. Today we're going to work on this chickadee painting. I'm going to do a tutorial. Hopefully it'll turn out for you. This has been a request from many of my readers. This was a sign here that I painted for a customer. Well, it's not really a sign. It's a painting because there's no wording going on it. It's not a sign. Of several local birds to hang in their home. And hopefully they will like it. We're going to paint on this board. It's also stained, not quite as dark, but it'll work. Now with these, I start with a small liner brush and a burnt umber for the eyes, so I can work around the eyes and see where they're going to be. So I just put in the little eyes. The black can nearly obscure the eyes, so it's kind of hard. But it seems that the burnt umber works to keep them more visible. So let me come back in with black. Okay, that was a liner brush. Now for the birds, I'm going to use, I think, we'll see how this works, a number 6 flat brush. This one is a low Cornell flat 6 7300 series. It's a little narrower, give me a little more control on the smaller birds. I'm going to start with doing their beaks and the glare from this light. It's making it a little hard for me. Let's see if I can see this little guy's beak. And then I'll just follow the outline of its head. There. That peak in the back. And it comes and it makes a V shape there. Be real careful around that eye so I don't get too much on it. And the same with this one. I'm using the chisel edge of my brush. And I just sort of fill in and go around that eye. You will outline a little bit with a little white on the eye. And then I come back in with his throat. And you just follow your pattern, basically. Hopefully I'm not getting in the camera. Okay, let me see if you can see this guy. Oh, scoot this guy over a little bit so we can see him. Now get the beak. And you can be choppy with your strokes because it'll emulate a little bit the feathers. Oh man, let's see if I got them all. I think I got them all of them. Well, his beak needs to be a little sharper. Okay, let's see, that's the black for now. I think the legs can be black and I can come in with a liner, very skinny liner, do their little legs. Real light because they don't have big fat legs. Kind of curve their, that foot's not really on the branch, but if you really hate it, you can always cover it with a leaf. Let's see where this guy's legs are at. Those are just kind of underneath his body, and you're just going to draw his little feet curving around that branch. And the other guy's gonna, should have a leaf under it, which I failed to draw in, but that can be fixed. Okay, we'll let the black dry a little bit as we load up with our white, and I'll get the white on my palette in a minute. Sorry, I didn't mean to be confusing. I'm not going just with the white right now. I'm gonna do the tail. Try to work from the bottom up with birds. The feathers come up over top of each other, so I'll do these here, then I'll do the brown or the golden color, because the white feathers come up over top of it. So I'm blending or double loading, just so you know, most people want to know, double loading black and the white on my palette, in my brush, and then I will, well, let's work on this one, stroke the feathers for the tail. And in my picture, they're more gray than black, but the white kind of really blends that out. And if I decide to, I can come back with gray. No, it looks like the white's gonna do the job. So there's the tail. Let's see, I'll do this guy over here, his tail. And the pattern is really just a guideline to keep me where I need to be. And just kind of chop in the strokes. If you want an area that's lighter, you just add a little bit more white to there. All right, there's his tail. And this little guy, his tail is hidden behind the other bird, but part of his wings are the gray. So we'll go ahead and put in his wings, and then it kind of overlaps here, but I'll just go over that black again later. I think it needs a little more white on it. And you see how choppy my strokes are, and that kind of emulates. Got some black, or white in my black. The feathers. Now also this guy's his feathers on the back side are also the gray. So I'm kind of looking at my original painting and the drawing to see where to put the different colors. Nice white in it, so I'm gonna bring in some more. Okay, I think that is enough of the blend of the white and the black. Well, after saying that, I noticed that this one has got more of these leaves, or leaves, these feathers are the black and white, so you always lead with your lighter color. And you just chop them up there, chop them on in layers. You work up because the bottom layers are always underneath the top layers, and I have too much black, so I'll go back for some more white and just bring them in there. Now looking at my picture again, it shows it's a little more black along the edges of this tail here. So then I'll go back over this with the white and black. There's one streak that's kind of very black right here. And you just work it until you're happy. And remember, sometimes less is more. You can overdo it, and sometimes I do, so I have to stop myself. But that looks good for now, so we'll stop there. Alright, now we're going to do the mostly white. Then my white here has a tiny bit of black in it from where I was double loading, but that's okay. We're going to do the part that's primarily white on these birds. See how it kind of comes down over that gray. And I'll do this one over here. And this one. And once you're almost done, you'll find any little areas that you need to touch up, but that is fine. I'm gonna get the burnt umber and mix it with my white to do the bellies. One moment. Okay, I have the raw umber and white blended into my brush the same way I blended all the other colors. And I'm going to come in and do the lower bellies that have a golden color. And I kind of guesstimate how far up I want that golden color. It might be a little too golden, so I just mix in more white. Again, I keep looking at my photographs or pattern pictures. And then I'm starting to lose the chisel edge, which means I need to clean my brush out. My paint's getting too gloppy in my brush. So. Choppy, choppy, choppy strokes. Same with this one. And you keep working it until you're happy. Now I'm coming back with just pure white to finish up their necks. And let's see. You're going to go down, chop over the burnt umber part. So it looks like a feathers. I keep wanting to say leaves, I don't know why. And I might have that burnt umber just a little too dark on this one, but, or raw umber, sorry. But that's okay, we're gonna fly with it this time. Crease there in the board, so it's getting kind of tough. I didn't do his black right, so he's going to be a little challenging, but I'll come back with his black cap and fix that. Now if there's anything else you need fixing, go ahead and do it now. I notice this guy's wing is kind of chopped off. And I will fix the cap on this one, Chickadee. Got kind of cut off. It should come down more like that. Now, for the eyes, I will come back. I'll get a liner brush and come back and show you how to outline the eyes. Now I get a very tiny liner. This is a 10/1 Low Cornell liner brush, and I basically just kind of go underneath the eye with a very tiny thin line of white to kind of highlight that area. And if you get it too thick or you don't like the shape, you can always go back over with black and do it again. So this one I'm going to go around like more than halfway around it. And then I get enough to put a little dot in there for a pupil, I guess. And there you have your Chickadees. Now, like I said, you can go back in and tweak anything you really don't like and until you're happy with it. But sometimes it's good to walk away and then come back and then you realize it looks pretty good and you don't need to tweak it anymore. Now I will find a pencil that I used, an eraser, to make the berries.